Hi guys, and welcome to my RCMA No Colour powder review. So I love this product already, but I'm doing a full day review, and this is 3 ounces, and it's $12 on Beautylish. It used to be 10 when I bought it, and the Mary Luminizer is 0.3, just so you guys have a price comparison. So I'm going in with my normal Fit Me foundation, and I'm also mixing it with the L'Oreal Lumi foundation, which is not that great. Honestly, it made my foundation wear off really quickly today, so that was kind of a mistake. So now I'm actually taking the powder and I'm putting it to the lid, and this is very messy, but for the price it's just worth the packaging failure, but you can repackage it. And I'm actually going in with my face brush and I'm going to apply a thin layer pretty much all over my face, just because I want to set the foundation well, because the Lumi doesn't last very well. So I'm just applying that all over there. And now with my Maybelline Fit Me Concealer in 10 Light, I'm putting it on my spots. And with the 15 Fair, I'll be applying it to my under eye just to brighten. And I'm going to blend that out with my Damp Beauty Blender, as you can see. And then I'm going to move on to the actual baking, which involves the Damp Beauty Blender. And I'm going to apply the No Colour powder under my eyes with the Damp Beauty Blender. And this is my favorite way of doing this. And I'm just going to leave it on for quite a while and pack it on around there just to, not brighten, but set the area really well. Because it is a no color powder, it won't help you with brightening. It makes sure that your foundation and concealer stays the same color. And I'm applying that to my chin and my forehead because my forehead does get oily and I want to keep it matte. So I did the rest of my makeup and I did more contour on one side than the other. And I was lazy, so I didn't bring my brush upstairs once I brought it down. So I'm just blending that out with my fingers. But I did blend out under my eyes and everywhere else, so there wasn't just a giant layer of powder on it. Excuse the hair, it was being annoying. But it is 10 o'clock, so I was about to leave for school at this moment. And I will check in later, but I also took flash photos so you guys can see that there is no flashback. Hey guys, so I'm back home from school and this hair thing is getting very, very annoying. But it's about 3, well actually on the stove it says 3:15, I'd say it's 3:10. And yeah, this is what the makeup looks like. I'm gonna zoom in and I'm gonna focus just to make sure it's actually focused right. So as you can see, there's no extra creases. These creases here are ones that I naturally have. So there's nothing I can do about it. The contour line, if you can see, is still looking pretty sharp, especially on this side, because I actually did more contour on this side by accident. I just didn't feel like re-dipping the brush because I'm stupid. I'm still extremely matte, and it is pretty warm outside today. And the only place that I'm not, oh, and now the sunshine's coming in. That's actually perfect. That's what it looks like in the sunlight, I guess. And I have highlighter over here, like on my eyebrows, underneath it, and here, and there, and there, but I rubbed that off earlier. That is what my under eye looks like. It's actually kind of scary to see it that close. The sides of my nose look pretty good. Usually they look like a disgusting cakey mess, so I'm happy with it. It's not... like, usually my under eye looks really scaly, and it looks pretty nice. Okay, so it's now 6-something. What time is it?
6:10.
6:10.
It's been 3 hours.
So, it's been 3 hours since the last check-in. This is going to be the last one with natural lighting, because as you can see, it's already dark. I'm out of breath. I just went up the stairs. But, yeah, this is what it looks like. I've had the powder on since 10 o'clock this morning, so it's been 8 hours. So it's already a full day of work, so definitely, if you are, oh, there's some fake lighting now. If you are wondering about if this would last the full work day, yes it will. My forehead just has, you know, ugly stuff wrong, but still no creasing. Around the nose is fine. Oh, and I accidentally wiped my face a little bit on a towel on this side.
And it still doesn't look bad. Like, it just, I guess, rubs off quite nicely. And it is invisible. It's a no color powder, so that's what it's going to look like. I'm going to take another flash picture right now just to see the difference. I'll just do one last check-in at night with, like, total fluorescent lighting. But this does last absolutely all day. I've done it before. I'll check in right before I wash my makeup off.
Okay, this is my last update. I don't have the mic on the camera because it's just too much work to put it on and whatever. But this is final look. It's like 8-something, almost 8:30. So it's lasted 14 hours? No. No. Yeah. No.
In 10 hours.
10 hours. 10 hours. But that's enough for me. I don't need it to last longer than that. My forehead is still matte. I'm going to zoom in because it's hard to tell with the light. It's under my eye, nothing different from last checkup. My foundation is fading though. Because remember, this is a no color powder, so it's not going to help with color at all. It's just the foundation that's faded, and you can still see my contour. It's not as crazy as this morning though. But that's it. Powder worked well, and it feels really silky until now under my eyes and stuff. It does look really dry though, but that's like my under eyes generally look really dry. My color looks really cool right now though, so that's kind of cool. It looks more hazel than usual, but yeah, under here I just use a regular moisturizer. I don't have an eye one, but one day, like I said, it'd be cool to, you know, get those filled out so it can be like this. So maybe when I'm like closer to 30, I'll get that done. So that's cool. I would definitely rate this a 10 out of 10. Highly recommend you buy it. It's $12 now, US. If you can get your hands on it now, I'd say get it now. Because I feel like they're going to raise the price even more because of how high the demand is. Like I said before, I got it for 10, but I highly, highly do recommend. And yeah, so I hope you guys like this review. Give it a big thumbs up, or just a normal thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you back next week, or just very soon, with a new, probably makeup-related video. If not, it might be a fun collab video. So, yeah. See you guys soon. Bye!